accelerate. We're gonna start with some glute bridge. And so just be laying on the ground.
And maybe just get a good stretch while you're down here to start.
Oh my gosh, there was one day we were doing a bunch of like push-ups and other things like that, and then as soon as we were done and I was like coming to clean up all my stuff, I saw this gigantic spider crawling around. We're gonna start with some glute bridges. And it was like right where I had been, and I was like, ugh. And so now I'm always like thinking about that while I'm down here. Okay, then we'll just do a hold in the glute bridge. Keeping your hips up high, glutes tight, feet flat on the ground. All right, and then we'll go into like a little march. So we'll pick up one leg and put it back down, pick up the other leg. We'll do 10 more seconds in our march. All right, and then we'll just go back to those raises. Maybe resting at the bottom for a second if you want. And just nice and controlled with your spine, bringing it up and down one vertebrae at a time. Squeezing those glutes up at the top. All right, and then 3, 2, 1, we're gonna hold. Hips up high, glutes tight. All right, 3, 2, 1, and then we'll march. Back to the raises. We're gonna do this one more time through. Just some nice, easy glute bridge raise. And then 3, 2, 1, we'll hold at the top. Getting those hips as high as you can. More seconds here. All right, 3, 2, 1, now we'll march. Ten more seconds for marching. 3, 2, 1. All right, now we're going to roll on over and we're just going to do a low plank hold. I'm just going to go straight into it, but you know, you can kind of stretch out and move as you feel. You need some ankle rolls or something. I'll just kind of hang out in a low plank. Really trying to get active with your shoulders, pushing the ground away, squeezing that belly button to spine. All right, and then we'll go ahead and rotate over onto one side. And so if you want, you can have your knees up or you can have your knee down and that top leg up, any style you want. Taking some nice deep breaths. All right, and then 3, 2, 1, we'll switch to the other side. And again, any variation is great. Rotate to the other side. 10 more seconds, and then we're gonna go back to forward again. We're gonna do 2 more times. 3, 2, 1, forward plank. Keeping those shoulders active, belly button is fine. Nice good breaths. 10 more seconds. 3, 2, 1, side plank. Seconds on this side. 3, 2, 1, switch sides. Ten more seconds. 3, 2, 1. And rest. Whew, good job. Here, maybe a little stretch. Nice little plank warm up. Now go ahead and stand up for the next part. It'll take this minute to like grab a sip of water if you need, or anything else that you want. But next we'll just kind of make some like walking passes. So we're just gonna go like back and forth. And the first one is just going to be the like walking deadlifts or like the turtle herders, where we're just kind of taking a short step, keeping your legs straight and like bowing forward. But we still have like 20 seconds to rest. You can start if you want, but. And yeah, we'll just be doing these for a minute. And you can go if you're ready. And again, keeping your legs pretty straight, just like bowing to the ground. Keeping your back flat. And just little steps are good. And we have another 30 seconds to do these. Taking your time and getting lots of reps, really stretching out that hamstrings. Probably feels good after practicing last night, or maybe, I guess. I feel like maybe not everybody has really tight hamstrings. One, and then the next one we're going to do is a little duck walk. So you're going to keep your hips as low as you can and try to just like walk forward. Nice! Yeah. And we're going to do like 10 more seconds of forward walking, and then we're going to like go for a loop and try to go backwards in our duck walk. Okay, 3, 2, 1, so now you're going to try to go backwards. And also think about like sitting your heel down and your butt back. And you can't tell if there's a spider coming out behind you. Just second. But then we're gonna do like a Cossack squat, but you're gonna try to stay low as you bring your leg back to the other side. And so like reaching and squatting over and just staying low. So kind of the same concept, but like side to side. And we're gonna go all to the right. So if you get to the end of your thing, just keep going to the right. And then we'll switch directions in 10 seconds. Or again, if you started going to the left, you know what I mean. Just stay in that same direction for 30 seconds. 3, 2, 1, now we'll switch directions. Alright, 10 more seconds, and then we're going to go to the duck walks. So 3, 2, 1, 30 seconds for forward duck walks. Getting all the crunchies in my knees and my ankles.
Yeah, this feels really good. Just sort of like a massage the whole way.
Yeah. Okay, 3, 2, 1, going the other way. I was thinking that too. I was like, just the way my ankle is moving is almost like massaging my ankle at the same time. Directions. Shake that out a little bit. Okay. Next, okay. Also, I did say no box today, but I kind of lied. We're going to use something that you're going to like balance your foot. So you don't really need to step on it, and it doesn't have to be that high either. So, and then also if you don't have that, it's totally fine to do without it. But the first thing we're gonna do is actually just alternating reps, standing, no weight, just hinging and tapping your opposite toe. And so we'll just do 20 reps of these, like 10 per side. Really trying to keep your back flat. And just cycle through the reps, like staying balanced and controlled. Just like planting that foot, hinging forward. And you know, it's not a race, but like just trying to get these reps done, like doing them quick. And it's 20 reps. Each one counts, so 10 per side. And then for the next one, once you're done with those, you're gonna need your cinder block. Or whatever else you're using for today. And this is where your little kickstand is going to come into play if you want it. And so now we're going to do a single leg deadlift with the weight. So it'll be like more challenging than just those weighted ones. And your back leg, you're going to just prop up on this back kickstand, whatever you have, your chair or your bench or whatever. So you don't necessarily have to worry as much about balancing because you have this like back foot balanced. So it's gonna be a single leg deadlift just on that one leg, but your back foot kind of has a little bit of a kickstand for support. And so that way you can like maybe go a little bit heavier and do more reps just on this one leg without having to worry about the balance as much. And so you'll kind of get to that comfortable place and you'll have that, the non-working leg is gonna be behind you, your working leg is out front, and you're just gonna hinge forward, keeping your hips high and just bowing forward, back flat. And we're gonna do 10 reps. And just again, nice and slow and steady. But the idea being you get all these 10 reps in without worrying as much about balance. And you can really just like get a good hold of your cinder block. And just going as low as, you know, your like hamstrings and keeping your back flat really allows. If you have to start rounding your back or bending your knees, you can just come right back up. It doesn't have to go all the way down. And again, we're gonna do 10 reps per side. Once you've got your 10, you'll switch sides. Oops. And again, trying to keep most of your weight on your front foot. And if you find your foot's kind of like hovering and not really touching the bench, that's also totally fine. Because again, it's really just there to kind of help you stay stable to do all 10 reps with the weight. Okay, and then the next thing we're gonna do, I think we might have tried this one other time. So if not, it might be new for you. But we're gonna do like a walking swing. And so as the kettlebell comes back, you know, and you're starting to stand it up and coming back forward, you're gonna like take a step forward. And then it swings back, and as you swing forward, you're gonna take a step forward. And so you can practice with like a couple of these staggered swings to kind of see what it feels like when you're in that staggered stance for your swing. But if you've done these before or you're ready to just kind of get right into them, you can start with that staggered stance, and then again, as you swing forward, you're gonna step forward. And we're gonna do 20 or 10 per set.
All right.
Now I'm feeling it. And those are our three movements. So after you finish your swings, we just go back to no weight. And so these ones, you know, you get a chance to kind of check in on your balance again a little bit and just try to get, and already feeling off now that I did those weighted ones. But again, just try to do those like fast, but staying balanced and controlled through the 20 alternating ones. And then 10 per side, weighted with the kickstand, and then 20 swings. And we have just about like 10 more minutes to do like maybe two or three more rounds. And so you can decide if you want to like add weight or how much you want to rest, but we'll just work through these three movements at your own pace for the next little bit.
Sweet.
And you know, you can always yell at me if you need, or if you want, if you just want to yell at me. Nice future. Love that cinder block. I'm definitely feeling that pump in my low back. And yeah, take like a minute or so between sets to sip on your water and your coffee. Ooh. Okay, we have about 4 more minutes for this part. Just about 4 more minutes, so perfect amount of time to do another set. Future. Nice job. Okay, we'll take a short break, and then we have one more thing, but I have to go pee really quick.
too much coffee already.
It's so funny. Whenever I run through the bunny room, she like thumps at me. She's like, "Get quiet in here." Okay, the next part we're gonna do is gonna be like a series of movements that we'll just like repeat over and over for 3 minutes, and then we'll rest 1 minute, and we're gonna do it 4 times. And so you'll have one item, and the first movement is gonna be 2 push-ups to your cinder block or your weight or whatever it is. And you can, if you have 2 weights, you can have 1 in each hand, and that'd be fine too. But it starts with 2 push-ups. And again, you know, you can do these push-ups in a plank, or you could do them on your knees, or a combination of both, whatever works. And then from here, you're gonna, again, on your knees or in the plank, you're gonna pull each weight up to your chest. And if you have 1 weight, then you'll just stay on your knees and put both hands on it and just do 2 kneeling rows up to your chest. And so basically it's gonna be like 2 of everything or 1 on your right, 1 on your left. And so then after you do your 2 push-ups and your 2 rows, you're gonna like step your feet up to meet your weights, but you're gonna stay hunched over in this position. And then you're gonna row again, either 2 times or 1 with each hand. And so you did like the kneeling row, now you're doing this like crouched standing row. And then from here, we're gonna do a clean. And so again, you'll do a clean on your right, and then a clean on your left, or you'll just do 2 cleans with both hands on your weight. And then we're gonna do the same thing with swings. And for your swings, if you have 2 hands, you'll just do 2 swings with both weights, or you'll do 2 swings with 2 hands on your weight. And so it's push-ups, plank row, and then step up, and this like from the ground crouch row, then cleans, then swings. And it's 2 of everything for 3 minutes, and then we'll take a 1 minute break. And just keep going. We'll do that 4 times. Cool, cool. Okay, great. We'll start in 10 seconds. Now that we had a nice long break. Okay, so it starts with 2 push-ups. 3, 2, 1, go! Yeah, 2 push-ups. 1, 2, and then the plank row. And again, your knees can be down for these, especially if you've got 2 hands on your cinder block and you're rowing up 2 times. And then you step up for that, like from the ground, deep crouch row. And then we'll do clean, clean, swing, swing. And then back to the push-ups. And the numbers stay the same the whole time, just always 2. And we're 1 minute in.
And it's always the same reps to you. It doesn't increase, right?
Yes, yeah. Always the same reps.
And it's always 2?
It's always 2. Yeah. One more minute.
Okay.
30 more seconds. More seconds, and you can pick up where you left off, or you can start back at the beginning, like whatever is easier for you. You know, if you're in like the cleans and you just want to like start back at the beginning rather than pick it up and do some swings, like that's totally fine. One more minute. Seconds. Two more times. This is getting me really sweaty.
Yeah.
30 more seconds to rest. I feel like the first minute I do it like 5 times, and the last minute I do it like 1.5. We're halfway through the set. Left. More seconds. One more time. Good stuff. Seconds. Thank you. 1 minute left. Seconds. 3, 2, 1.